In this video, we will learn to find the limit of 1 upon square of sine of x minus 1 upon square of x as x approaches 0. Let us assume L is the limit of 1 upon square of sine of x minus 1 upon square of x as x approaches 0. As x approaches 0, 1 upon square of sine of x approaches infinity and 1 upon square of x also approaches infinity. So we can see that the limit L is in indeterminate form infinity minus infinity. Let us try to further simplify the limit to avoid this indeterminate form. The difference of the fractions is equal to square of x minus square of sine of x upon square of x times square of sine of x. In the above limit, I have factorized the numerator as x plus sine of x times x minus sine of x. As multiplying the numerator and the denominator of a fraction by a common factor does not change the value of the fraction, so let us multiply the numerator and the denominator by square of x. So L is equal to limit of square of x times x plus sine of x times x minus sine of x upon x raised to the power of 4 times square of sine of x as x approaches 0. We can rewrite the above limit as product of three limits. So L is equal to limit of x plus sine of x upon x times limit of square of x upon square of sine of x times limit of x minus sine of x upon cube of x as x approaches 0. Here I have rewritten the above limit as L is equal to limit of 1 plus sine of x upon x times limit of 1 upon square of sine of x upon x times limit of x minus sine of x upon cube of x as x approaches 0. We know limit of sine of x upon x as x approaches 0 is equal to 1. The limit has been proved in the video appearing in the upper right corner of this video. The link of the video is also given in the description section. So application of the above fact gives us L is equal to 1 plus 1 times 1 upon square of 1 times limit of x minus sine of x upon cube of x as x approaches 0. Further simplification gives us L is equal to 2 times limit of x minus sine of x upon cube of x as x approaches 0. We know the Taylor series expansion of sine of x is equal to x minus cube of x upon factorial of 3 plus x raised to the power of 5 upon factorial of 5 minus so on. The Taylor series expansion of sine of x has been derived in the video appearing in the upper right corner of this video. The link of the video is also given in the description section. Here, I have replaced sine of x by its Taylor series expansion. Here I have taken off the brackets. Further simplification gives us L is equal to 2 times limit of cube of x upon factorial of 3 minus x raised to the power of 5 upon factorial of 5 plus so on upon cube of x as x approaches 0. As every term has cube of x as common factor, so I have taken out the common factor cube of x out in the numerator. After cancelling out the common factor cube of x, we get L is equal to 2 times limit of 1 upon factorial of 3 minus square of x upon factorial of 5 plus so on as x approaches 0. As the limit L has become a polynomial function. A polynomial is continuous at every point of real number line, so we can plug 0 for x. Further simplification gives us the limit L is equal to 2 upon factorial of 3. Further simplification gives us the limit L is equal to 1 upon 3.
Thank you for being with me. I hope you like this video. Please click the like button and subscribe button. Do not forget to press the notification bell so that you get the notifications of my new videos. Share the video and do write in the comments. I am eager to listen to your thoughts. If you have any question related to video, if you think I should make a video on any other topics in which you are interested, please write in the comments. Thank you.